You're listening to the AfterBuzz TV Network, now the largest new media platform on the web, and your number one source for after-show entertainment.
Very good, Keith
Johnson.
The AfterBuzz Studios in Los Angeles, California. Presented by Maria Menounos and Bing.com. And streaming live thanks to Akamai Technologies. This is AfterBuzz TV's Nashville After Show. We'll break down tonight's episode and get you all the latest news and gossip. If you'd like to buzz in on tonight's show, you can buzz us at 424-256-1729. That's 424-256-1729. And now, another post-game wrap-up show for your favorite TV show. It's AfterBuzz TV's Nashville After Show.
Yeah!
Yeehaw! That's tough.
Woohoo!
Oh.
All right. A new one, right? Nice. I like it,
yeah.
Melissa.
Good song. Hey guys, Bing is for doing, and we're here doing the Nashville AfterBuzz show for episode 12 called I've Been Down That Road Before. We're so excited because we had a week off and now we came back, which is a killer episode. Oh, so we'll get right to it. I'm a host, JJ Jurgens, and I'm joined here with...
I am Lauren Leonelli.
Whitney Lane.
And I am Keetin Marchi back again.
Yay!
Good to have you back. Yeah. We love it.
Good to see ya.
I can't even.
Where do we start?
If you all just watched us watching the show, screaming, grabbing each other, like in shock the whole time. So
it
we've got
like,
good stuff to talk about.
I think I grabbed JJ's arm like a million times and probably bruised her.
You were grabbing my arm.
Dying.
I'm slouched down this.
I'm shocked, like literally screaming out loud.
We
know,
you guys at home were doing the same.
Yeah.
It was so good.
So many tweets.
I mean,
I certainly was.
Marissa, our engineer,
gasping.
Like dying.
So many things we've been waiting for 12 episodes, and we finally
got
like a bunch of them tonight.
It
oh my
great.
God!
Well, it's that we've been down that road before. We get all is coming back around, so we're glad to see it.
What do you think that meant? What do you think that title meant?
Oh, you know, they're all going back to kind of like, at least Rayna and Deacon have been down that road. Teddy and Peggy,
but they haven't really though. They haven't really been down that
well,
road.
Well, the whole, like, let's argue again and, like, let me go on Juliette's tour, but then she's jealous. It's like the whole
True. But they took it a step further this time.
Well, are we saving that or are we talking about it now?
Well, on the
brakes.
We're
going
to
save
it. Okay, we'll save it.
Yeah, we want to save the big stuff. We're going to start out talking tonight about... Let's talk about Scarlett and Avery and Gunnar.
Gunnar is getting hot.
Okay, you guys all thought he was hot tonight.
He looked good.
Marissa, did you think he looked extra hot tonight?
I think so. I like the disheveled look.
The hair.
I liked it.
The facial hair and like the scruffiness. Yeah. All of us were like, why is he so hot this episode?
Thank goodness. Because for a while I was like, I don't know, you know, and now I'm like, good, somebody else to look at on the show. I'll take as many of them as possible.
He went a little bad boy. Like, you know, he brought up more about his brother being in prison and his past. And I was just like,
yes, you like Keetin, you like that.
Apparently
Maybe
she does.
I love it.
From that reaction.
You know, I love Scarlett this episode, actually. And I know we always are like, come on, girl, get it together. We can't understand you. But she was like, she had some strength to her words this time. And she wasn't just letting Avery walk all over.
After the words were all mashed up, then there was a little strength behind
it. Was,
them.
And
there
I was proud
though.
Of her.
There was.
She's like, you know what? I'm not taking his crap. I want my money. Gunner's in my house now. Walk away. You're pathetic. I love that line, which told Avery that he was pathetic. Exactly what needed to be done.
And after they had that little fight, you know, the little punching match, I thought maybe there was going to be a moment where she was going to feel sorry for him, like, oh, he just got the crap beat out of him, he's laying on the floor, and then she looked at him and she was like, get out of our house.
I loved it. Finally, you know, now she felt sorry for Gunnar, and he deserves it. He's a good guy.
I know. She showed some humor, too, like her line when Gunnar was talking about moving in and was saying, like, what if I, you know, bring a girl home, or what if I bring two? And, you know, she had her little
she was like, keep dreaming.
That was cute. Yeah,
that was
she
cute.
Had a few moments that we all made us all like her a little bit tonight.
I'm glad. I'm really glad. And it looks like some big things are going to be happening for him after the whole music. You know,
Wadi.
Raina's really interested and talked to Wadi about the two.
Can I just say something? We haven't seen Wadi since episode one, correct? And he comes in, and we're all like, oh, it's that guy. And I'm sure you viewers at home are like the same thing. And Rain Man over here, Whitney Lane, she's like, oh, that's Waddy White. And we're like, she knows everybody's freaking name. Like, I'm kind of bad with that, so I'm like idolizing her memory over here. But
you know that comes back to bite you in the butt sometimes. So when you're like, oh, I've met you, you're blah, blah, blah. And they're like, don't know you. And I'm like, this is awkward. But in this instance, it was nice. Us out a lot.
It was nice to see Waddy because he's like, I like that he's a cheerleader for Gunnar and Scarlett.
He sees true talent, I
and
think.
He's also a constant for Rayna. It seems like he's somebody who like has always let Rayna be herself and be true to herself and supported her through that. So
that's true,
and I think that's why.
And kind of grounds her a little bit too. I think it makes her remember some of the most moments that she used to have with Deacon and how good they were.
Mm-hmm. And I think that's why he's such a cheerleader for Gunnar and Scarlett, because he said, and we have all said it a million times, they are so much like you and Deacon. And so that I will save for predictions, but something is happening there.
I'm glad.
If I can say,
they're talented. They deserve it, I think.
Oh, yeah.
I'm not sure if I can say this word on here, but can we talk a little bit about what a douchebag Avery is?
Yeah, we should say douchebag. Why not? Why can't we
like,
say?
Here's a total douchebag.
Yeah. He's really, the worst.
Bringing the TV crew, let's talk about that, what he did to Scarlett.
She called him out, too, which is like, what, you bring him around because you want to impress me? You're pathetic. I mean, she knows. Mm-hmm. Like, he's not even worth it. He's lonely now. Gunnar called him out on that as well. Mm-hmm. It's like he misses what he had, and it's too bad because it all came back to bite him in the butt.
That's exactly what it is. His character is so, lonely and damaged, and I do really believe when he brought the money back to Scarlett, he did really feel bad. Granted, he dug his own grave, I'm not saying, but yeah. I think he has those moments constantly through the show where he's like, I'm desperate, I want whatever I can do to make it to the top, and then he does it, and then his conscience kicks in. Too late, though. It's always too late. Then he goes, oh, shoot, I shouldn't have done that, and then he really does genuinely feel bad. However, he makes bad decisions first, and he always lets that take over.
I think he always has other motives as well. Absolutely. When he came back with that money, I'm thinking maybe he does feel bad, but I think he also misses the whole Scarlett Avery relationship. He kind of wants it back, and he's going to try what he has to do.
Yeah, it's a little selfish for sure.
Always selfish. Yeah. Avery is selfish. We know that.
Do you think there's any way he will ever be able to redeem himself at this point? Mm. Or does he just have too many flaws?
Well, if people are better than him and they have, generosity in their bones and actually accept people if they've changed, maybe. Because some people seem like they have hearts, and so maybe if he really does change and can prove that somehow, but as of right now, I think that's the storyline and where he's headed.
Man. Yeah, he has to do a lot, because, he's still with Marilyn, right? Is that,
well,
is that her name?
Yes, name. You got it.
Even though he tried to storm out this.
They are such a funny couple. One second he's, telling her off and, it's like they're fighting to be the alpha male the whole time. Like, who's it going to be this time? And one moment it's her and one moment it's him. And she's like, you know what? Can I just give you advice? Just get over it. That was her alpha male moment. But, a couple episodes ago, he was with Wyclef's character. What was his name? Whitney?
Dominic.
Dominic.
I hope I'm right on that.
No, you are.
I'm ding.
And he kind of took, he was like, well, Dominic got me a car, blah, 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 So, they have these moments where, one's being an ass and the other.
She did say at the end, she was like, let's be honest, we're both using each other to get to where we want to be. So, dumb, but she's having her cake and eating it too, basically.
She sure is. Although none of you think that that looks like a good piece of cake.
No.
Or is everyone shaking their head? I don't think he's that bad. He's not really my type, but he's not as bad as you all are whoa! Every time he comes on the screen, I'm like, he's all right. It's Joshua Jackson.
He's a great person.
Jackson. Yeah. Joshua. That's a different actor.
I think it's his personality that really makes it, and then the long hair and the little just get rid of that and cut the hair. Get a Gunnar haircut. Come on.
Hello,
give you so much hotter.
You're totally right. That's exactly right.
You're right. No, he's not. But he's his personality does make him less attractive for sure.
Yeah. I agree.
All right. So
let's move on to talk about Deacon and Juliette, and they're working together on the tour.
Man, that's just eating Rayna up, though.
Mm-hmm.
And
she doesn't like it.
Deacon, he's all about, I'd play guitar for anyone who pays me. But, he liked the little fact that he could come on a Juliette's tour and Rayna would be there, and he knew it would probably kind of push some buttons, which it does.
Right.
Mm-hmm. But how awkward were those elevator scenes?
Oh my god.
Oh, how many are there? Three elevator scenes. So and it's like they don't speak or something else is going on.
I almost feel like Deacon is getting more messed up by it than Rayna is. I feel like Rayna...
He's internalizing it, though, yeah.
I feel like Rayna, like, you see her in the elevator, she's just trying to be normal and just, like, talk it off. Deacon's the one who's internalizing it, like you said, and he's the one who went in for the kiss.
Totally.
I actually like to see, because I know, like, Whitney, you said when Deacon wasn't talking to Rayna, and you're like, grow up, like, how mature? And I am on the other side of that one, because finally. I feel like she has just drug him through the mud for so many years and just wants him around when she wants him around, but then she, you know, so I'm glad he did that to her. I think she deserved a little bit of that. And
I agree.
You know? Yeah.
I know, but I feel like at this point, it's like, say how you're feeling, because remember, Glenn comes up to him, he's like, all you do is sit around and think. You're not doing anything. And it's true. He doesn't. He just sits there and thinks and internalizes it. And then how's anybody supposed to read what he's thinking?
There's been a couple moments, though, throughout the season where he has tried to have, like, moments with her. And she always kind of was, you know, pulling him close and then pushing him away every time.
But I really, so. I mean,
but she should know, though. I mean, how much does he have to say? Like, this is an unspoken understanding between them. Like, but I get what you're saying, Whitney. Like, that's a good argument, but I just, I'm leaning more towards what you're saying.
No, I hear both sides, but I think she is, I think it's a little bit of her conscience pulling her back sometimes in the other situations, because it's like she wants to be with Deacon, but she's married at the same time, and that's how it's been for the past, what, 10?
20 years.
20 years, so it's like she wants to follow her heart, but she's listening to her mind in these instances, and I think that's why it's hard, because you want Deacon to, like, stand up for himself, and you want him to be like, hello, but she's, I know, I get it. She's not treating him how he should be treated, but what are you going to do when you've got a husband on the other
end? She does have that, like,
Do you think if Deacon actually would have gone up to her suite, what do you think were Raina's intentions when she texted him?
Good call. Yeah. Oof.
Like, did she want to, like, get it on, or did she want to just talk it out?
I think she wanted to talk.
Me too.
I think
it could have led to something else, but
she may have been like, well, if it turns into something else, but I think maybe she, or at least her conscious mind was telling her that so that she doesn't feel bad, right, Marissa?
What do you think, Marissa?
I think she called Deacon just, you know, well, texted Deacon just to talk, which could have led to something.
Right, exactly.
She would have been open to it.
Because, you know, they kissed, but so I think Rain is the kind of person who, you know, just wants to talk it out. Where do we go from here?
And also, I feel like it could have been like, let me open up about what's actually happening in my marriage at this point, because that could bring them closer to where it eventually is like, you know what, you don't have to wait much longer.
Good
That's
call.
That could have happened. Oh, wouldn't that have been good? Maybe next week.
Well, before we get into the meat of that,
I know.
We gotta talk about. So we have Juliette coming out, and she has all these crazy dancers and glitter. And
I was talking
about
shocked.
Her performance a little bit. And Deacon.
She was fine with that at first until she knew that Deacon kind of had a problem with it, and then she watched his reaction while she was on stage, and he was like not into it. And then all of a sudden, she like turned this corner where she's like, "Why this glitter won't come off my skin? This stupid. What if this isn't my brand?"
What do you mean, like, Deacon wasn't into that guy like grinding up on him?
That was such a great.
That
shot.
Wasn't cool to him.
That was hilarious.
Was awesome. Like his face was just.
He turned his head.
I loved it. I loved it. They were good dancers, but man, you could get why he's like a good old country boy. He's not trying to get into all that dancing and frou-frou act that she put on.
No.
I don't know.
It's like she's like a little high schooler. Like, it's like she wants to be like with the cool kids, and like whatever's cool at that moment, she has to be that.
Totally agree. Like, it's like whatever. And then when she goes to talk to Deacon about it later, it was a whole nother spin. It was like, well, I still want to give my, wait, no, that's not my Juliette voice. This is my Juliette voice. Well, I still want to give, no, that sounds like Scarlett. Anyway, she said, I still want to give my fans what they want to see, and
diplomatic, right?
Yeah, way too diplomatic. Yeah. I don't know.
She really was.
That's her demographic. You know, the young female, and that's what her they're
brand.
Into.
That's her brand. But to Glenn, her manager, which, I'm sorry, we have to talk about this for a second.
Ew, the hair.
What is going on with that guy's hair?
Is it real or is it a piece?
I don't know.
I'm going with toupee.
Even if it is real, I'm going to say color is not real. It is some weird peach color.
Tonight it was super high, too.
And it was.
It definitely got a little extra tease.
Very Texas hair.
It was very much like Miley Cyrus's do right now. Right up there.
I'm sorry. I know this has nothing to do with the storyline, but I'm just wondering if any of the viewers out there agree. It freaks me out. It's like borderlining Donald Trump. The Donald.
Great.
Anyway, so to Glenn, she's like the little, you know, she's being very like childlike, like whining and bitching about her brand. Like so petulant and weird. And then with Deacon, it's like, well, it's a whole other story. It was just weird to see her flip-flop like that. It made me feel like she really just wants to do whatever she can to make Deacon like her or accept her, or maybe she's really trying, like, subconsciously or consciously to be like Rayna and Deacon, like the next Rayna and Deacon. And she wants to do whatever she can to connect with him. And the glitter and the, all that jazz is not going to do it. You know what I mean?
It's weird. I mean, it's like she, it's maybe like she just wants that stability in her life, and she sees how Deacon was for Rayna. He really was like her backbone, you know, always there for her. And maybe that's what she's reaching for.
Well,
but
stability
it's just not going to happen.
Stability is always what she's reaching for. So that's a, a good
and
argument.
You know, she has emotions, and people are starting to learn about her life. Like, I mean, it's good to write songs and things like that, but I don't know. It's just not going to work for her. Yeah. Well, who knows, actually? YouTube might have worked for her, but the tweets were making her do her little ugly cry.
And she's so funny. She acts like she doesn't care what people think, and like she's that attitude like, I'm gonna do what I want all the time. Like she doesn't care. She's like one of those. And then someone tweets something like she doesn't look cute, and she's like, meh. Like
this episode particularly, the emotions were just all over the
roller
place.
Coaster just, central.
We're gonna see it next week too. I mean, she's becoming the biggest diva. Like I thought she was growing up. I thought she was changing a little bit.
She had a few moments where she made us feel like that was happening, but clearly is not her character.
She got Deacon back into the mix, and he just, like, riles her up.
Totally.
Like,
that
absolutely
must be
riles
it.
Her up. And just because she so wants to please him and do what she thinks he thinks is cool.
Exactly.
Like, I mean, she was just about to get married a few episodes ago, and now, like it's...
She's grasping for something, but I don't know.
Well, she's so jealous of what Deacon and Rayna had, you know, so it's like she's always, because from the start of this episode, she was in Raina's face, like from the beginning about it. She's so,
and
just like a taunting and,
totally.
You know,
the little dig she makes to Deacon, like, oh, you were always there for Rayna, or you should, she doesn't care about you. You know, she says those little digs to him, and he's like, well, yeah, I was always there for her. She's the one that chose to do and follow her heart.
He actually said, I wasn't always there for her this time, right? He said, I wasn't. So he's admitting, because she's always trying to blame Rayna for everything.
Exactly.
And
he's,
and, which she doesn't know about their past.
Right.
And you know, he's saying, actually, there was a lot of times that I wasn't there for her.
Yeah, and he has a reason. He brought up the whole, like, but she follows her heart, and Rayna picks what Rayna wants to do. And so then again, it's like Juliette's trying to, you know, kind of live up to what Rayna
Well, maybe
like.
That's why she's... Yes, but then she's all the flip side to that is she's also kind of trying to make Deacon feel like he has a voice and has a say. Like, she's not going to do what Rayna did. She's going to make him feel like he's really part of this partnership, or maybe I don't know, but which is why she went and did that song with him. And
do you think Deacon's maybe in some ways trying to turn Juliette into a mini Rayna, because he feels
it could
like
be
he
from
lost
both
her.
Sides?
I don't see it as much,
but he's
though.
Like, but he's like suggesting that she does what Rayna did. Like, obviously, Rayna had a very successful career, so that is a good reason to, like, model your career after hers. But then again, it's like, why are you encouraging her to be, like, the woman you're still in love with and who's had, like, your child, who you're on the same tour with? It's very strange the way he's playing.
It could be coming from him, too, but it's definitely more from her. Or it's just more obvious
from
her. Maybe, Deacon, like, he internalizes things or whatever. Maybe it's an underlying thing, but...
Or more, maybe it's just selfish. Maybe he wants to play the kind of music he wants to play, and he's like, I can't be having those guys dancing up on me, so kind of do some other stuff.
Right.
But Juliette asked Deacon, what would Rayna have done?
Yeah.
Right.
She did. She did.
Yeah. She's grasping
she's the
she
one
who like
her. Yeah. Yeah. She's the one who took it there.
Yeah. She's trying to live up to someone that she's just not right now.
Well,
so
speaking
we'll
of
see.
Someone that they're not, Peggy and Tata. Sorry, am I jumping? I've just
no.
We can jump. We can go there.
Time.
I mean, this is the thing though with the Peggy and Teddy thing. When they met, and she's like, "Let's just talk about like the white elephant in the room here," and then he kind of interrupted her, and she's like, "Hold on, I'm not. That's not what I'm saying." I think she was really like turned a corner and just wanted to be friends with him, and you know. Obviously, there are some past incidences where it's obvious that she had feelings, but I feel like she went through the divorce and she moved out and she's like on this new path and she's just trying to be there as a friend. And then she saw that genuine support that he was giving her. She was giving him like with no strings attached. She was really just like, I think
can we do it?
She didn't do that.
She touched his hand
she patted it twice. And then he's like, grab, hold on. And I was like, whoa.
And then he reached for her collar, and it was and like. It was
just... And grabbed her beret.
That damn beret. We were all dying in that moment, though. That was the first. Marissa, were you dying?
I was.
Screaming.
That was the first of the slouched.
It was. Oh, but you know what? I'm going to give props to Peggy, even though no one really seems to like her.
I like Peggy.
But she's always been honest.
Yeah.
Because you've always been able to see how much she cares for Teddy. She's mm-hmm. never, yeah. like, you know, told him otherwise. She never shown him otherwise. And she's always been super supportive, which is not what he got from Rayna. So totally. It's like, you know what? Maybe she deserves some happiness instead of, like, overdosing on pills.
She's sweet to Rayna, too. Like, if you ever see any of her interactions with Rayna, she is so kind to her.
I don't think she's trying to be like a horrible homewrecker. I think it was a bad situation they got involved in. She had feelings for Teddy, and she tried her best to like squash it and just be his friend. He made the move this time. And in his defense, I mean, whatever, he's married, he shouldn't have done it. But yeah. he really is just reaching for someone who mm-hmm. is going to support him and love him for him, like regardless of anything. And he never, ever got that with Rayna. And honestly, yeah. it's technically wrong. He's married, but I don't really blame the guy for like weakening in a moment where he finally got what he's been looking for the past 20 years.
No, maybe I think he deserves
or however
happiness.
Long they've been married.
He
you know?
Deserves happiness. Maybe, I would agree.
Maybe Teddy and Juliette should get together. They both seem to want Ugh. The same
they
thing.
They are like grasping for something. Yes.
Give me something.
I have a prediction about me. I have a prediction about Teddy and Peggy.
Well,
but
gotta,
yeah.
Gotta hold that one.
I will.
But mm-hmm. you know, with Teddy, it's like, I think, I understand completely where, I don't think he should have done what he's done. He also didn't open up and was honest with Rayna. However, on Raina's side, she's always been honest with him. She has not lied.
Omission.
I don't see nearly as much omission from her as I do from Teddy. He calls. Yeah. He's like, have you hung out with Deacon while you've been there? Have you seen Deacon? Have you seen Deacon before the tour? Mm-hmm. She was honest with
okay,
him. She
yeah.
told him.
Technically, on those things, yes, but... every day she's living a lie, staying married to the guy and pretending like, I mean, whatever. I'm not saying she doesn't love him yeah. at all. I'm not saying that. Clearly they have kids together or whatever. But look, let's be honest here. He's been searching for that spark, that magic that he talked about. And she has it with Deacon. Everybody sees it. He sees it. They're both living in denial. But she hasn't really been that forthright about just like, look, I'm having dreams that I'm making out with Deacon. Like, I have these moments with him on stage. I mean, well. she never lied. You're right. She yes. never lied. She's been honest, but she's not really telling him how
he
she really feels.
He also didn't tell
she's
her
not.
About the Cumberland deal.
Yeah,
he also didn't
think.
Tell her about sleeping with Pet. You know, there's so
but
many
he explained
huge
why.
Things.
He explained why he did
still
that.
Still huge. That's your relationship.
No, you're right. You're right.
Huge yeah. things that he's kept from her, and she really has, you know, she's opened up. He knows that. I think that was already known, because when they got married, he knew that she loved Deacon. He knew that. Like,
and
why
the baby,
you don't need
the
to
baby
bring
daddy.
It, and he knows all about that. So it's kind of like, why does she need to bring it up over and over if he already knows?
Yeah, I know.
She's just trying to be a good wife. Mm, and she really was. Yeah. I mean,
it's
good
sad,
intentions,
though.
But she shouldn't have done it.
True. Yeah, I'm torn with both of you guys. Yeah. I've said before, I don't believe that, like, I think she's done a huge disservice to the kids being in a marriage, a loveless marriage, and wanting somebody else, and obviously not telling the kid who her real father is. I just think that's completely damaging and wrong. But I do also see where I think she's trying to keep the family together, and she's tried to like stick through it. Yeah. And I do think that because of Teddy's lies and deception, that's made it harder for her to really be able to give him another chance and to open up and to have those looks of really loving him. If she always feels like, I don't really know who this guy is, and he's a liar and, you know, pretty much a crook the way
he's.
I
mean, obviously
it's
a tough relationship and it's ending. Or so Teddy.
Well,
so
I don't know.
About.
We haven't seen Raina's dad all episodes, so I wonder what his feeling is going to be on this situation now that he's
good
the mayor. So
he might not let that happen.
Yeah.
Well,
so let's yeah, we just have to.
There you go.
That's a big moment.
Set that one up.
I almost spilled my water. Rayna and Deacon, OMG.
Finally a kiss.
Finally.
They were
passionate.
Us.
But this is what they did. They did those previews for the next episode last on purpose to see they kiss in an elevator. And then they made us watch them get in an elevator like 800 times.
Yeah.
So every time they got in the elevator, I'm sure all you at home watching were like, oh my God, it's that. They're going to.
We're like, no, they're on the wrong side. Nope, no, wrong shirt.
We're like, oh, this is it. This
oh my God.
I loved when like they got in that last time. You're like, that's the shirt. That's the shirt.
This is time.
It's go time. We were all dying. I loved how he kissed her and then she tried to start talking, like that's probably another sign as to why she would probably text him and want to continue to talk. Yeah. And he goes, Rayna, I'm done talking.
Yeah.
And then just like goes in for the kill. Is like, oh.
And come on, that's the way to kiss. Just go in and go for it. And do you think it was awesome?
Do you think he was inspired by Glenn telling him enough, no doing, all you do is say, and he gets in there, like I'm done talking.
I do totally think Glenn inspired him.
Good, go Glenn, you and your hair.
Yay!
Making moves.
I don't know, Marissa.
Listen to him more often,
Marissa. Were you just like
I was dying?
Yeah.
I loved it. And I love the silence. Like, he just went for it. It's like, yes, go Deacon.
And then he just leaves.
Yeah.
I don't go.
Yeah. That's all.
He's like,
that's,
bam,
well,
drop
that's
the
all
mic.
You need.
Another great moment, because we were all waiting to see, like, who's, is somebody going to see him? Is Juliette going to be on when the elevator opened? And then it was just.
Because they were still kissing when the doors opened.
Yeah.
That made me nervous.
Was stressed.
I thought
out.
Someone was going to come
me
in.
Me totally did.
And I'm glad it hasn't yet.
But I think that's the perfect way for this couple. Through this 12 episodes, we have been watching the sexual tension like no other. There needed to be no anything. He just needed to do it. Mm-hmm. Like, that's all. It was perfect. Like, no explanation. And then she started talking. He's like, seriously, shut your mouth.
Yeah.
Except for to kiss me.
And it left you wanting more, because then you know there's a future with what's going to happen.
Because we've been waiting for this. It's like Dawson and Joey, you know. We've been waiting the whole freaking arc of the season. So if they're going to do this, they got to make us want more. So it's good.
And
he walked out. We did want more. I'm sure she wanted more, too.
He definitely
just
did.
Saying.
He didn't wait a second after that text she sent me. He was on his way to Penthouse One.
Mm-hmm. Penthouse One. Yeah, we could hardly read that text. We're all like, what is
it? Pause it. Go back.
But no, yeah.
So then he's on his way up there.
Yeah. And?
Well, when she gets a knock on the door, she's thinking, okay, here comes Deacon. Mm-hmm.
She was so freaking shocked when it was Teddy.
I was shocked.
Me too, but great acting on her part. Like, literally, her face, like, it, like, died.
Yeah.
Like, you know, it's just like, oh, my goodness.
That's not a good sign.
Yeah.
The way they cut that scene, if I think about it, I'm just like, oh.
I know.
It was really
so well done.
It was great, because I did not see it coming at all.
And
like,
it's not what you wanted either, so it's even more like, really, he's going to interrupt this again? Like,
and it was perfect way to keep us wanting more again. Like, if they're going to give us that kiss, like, in the first season, we need to have something like that happen.
Yeah.
And Teddy was the perfect interruption. Oh, perfect.
He walks around the corner. I'm like, oh gosh, is he gonna get caught? And then of course you see him like back up, like what's happening now? She's choosing her husband again. Been there, done that. How many times?
And
been,
we were
down
all
that
down that right.
That's
that road.
That's why. There you go.
That's what that
we
means.
We all also felt really, we were going to be sad for Deacon, because we were like, if he walks in and then she's in there, I don't know, we just want him to have a sad moment after he's been all like ballsy. And
in all fairness, it's not like Rayna made the move. He made the move. He knows she's married. He doesn't know they're having any problems. He just did that out of nowhere. So for him to see her husband, yes, I felt bad for him, because we're obviously rooting for Deacon, but I mean, it's her husband. As far as he knows, he's like, oh, shoot. Well, you know, I mean, he's the other man, so he can't be that, like, I mean, it sucks. I'm sure it hurts his ego, and it sucks because he finally got the guts after all these years, but it's her husband.
Well, this is the time for him, for Deacon, to actually not just jump to conclusions about why Teddy was there, but to actually communicate with her and talk, because then he won't just be like, oh, here she goes
again.
Oh,
like, that's going to happen.
He's
like,
why did he come? And I know,
we
but
need
you know,
Glenn to come back in. Come on, Glenn.
But
their relationship.
Hair ready. Let's go.
Good
stuff. Aquanet out. No, but their relationship, Deacon and Rayna, it sort of exists on a little bit of like not fully communicating and some misunderstanding.
Oh,
so in
sure,
order to
yeah.
keep this going the way it is, he's going to get mad and storm off, and she's going to, you know, and there's going to be like Three's Company Central.
Uh-huh.
Someone's going to misunderstand something, and it's wackiness ensues. Correct.
Yes.
I mean, this is what's going to happen.
Otherwise, you wouldn't have the drama.
Yeah, we still have what, like 9 more episodes.
Yeah.
But I kind of question when Deacon was going in there, I think we all sort of said this, or somebody did, that, oh my God, is she going to tell him it's the oldest daughter is his daughter? We were wondering about that.
That conversation.
That is going to be real good.
Oh, intense.
And I love how, like, what I've noticed with Nashville is that they, and it's either they give us a ton of information or they don't give us anything in an episode. And I loved how this was just chock full of just telling us things.
We needed it. These last couple,
we were just like, these are some good episodes.
Yeah, because they could have ended just when, after the kiss and just be the end of the episode. And then there was still more.
There was still more.
And it was still all shocking. Like, it didn't, like, go downhill. It was still keeping us.
I think they needed Teddy to have that full circle where he came and said, I don't know that they're trying to paint him as big of a villain as it is to make him a cheater. I think we see why he's doing it, even though technically it's wrong. We see where it's coming from. And we needed to hear him say to her, I don't feel that magic. I've been waiting for just to sort of not justify what he did, but at least to let you sympathize with what he's trying to find and how he's not getting it, to sort of explain where he's coming from. And then, of course, he had to drop the divorce bomb.
Do you think he is going to tell her that he slept with Peggy?
Yes.
Yeah.
I think he would if she asked. Mm-hmm. Or maybe he just will.
I think he's going to have
He will have too guilty of a conscience. And we've seen that guilty conscience really, really gets
with
it
to Teddy
eats away
at
him. And he needs to kind of let that out.
Could be years.
I think
could
he's not going to tell her for a while.
Yeah.
He has nothing
to
lose.
I think she's going to find out. Reyna's going to find out eventually from, like, someone
maybe
else.
Maybe Peggy.
Yeah. Wait, we need to save this for prediction. because we're... No, but I agree. Yeah. I think we should do a little prediction on that.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. Sorry, I just totally, like, took our thunder. I'm like, stop talking, everybody. No, but I think we could. Yeah, I don't know. I really am glad that he went in there and said all that, though. I could have ended on the kiss for me, but I was like, I like he was honest. I like that he. And then the divorce thing. So we see that it really affects Rayna too. This divorce thing.
That's what I think. And you even see in the preview, mm-hmm. kind of like
she goes.
Did
out,
she not expect that this was going to happen? Yeah. Like, she thought she could be the one to hold all the ropes. You
well,
know, like
that's
could
how
control
she always,
it.
Yeah. She has
been, I know.
Yeah. And she starts acting like a young girl in her 20s that just broke up with her boyfriend, like, goes out and, like, hooks up with a bunch of dudes and gets drunk and, like, acts. She's like,
yeah, I'm not. I was pretty disappointed in that from what I've seen of the promo for next time. Yeah,
she's a mom.
But she's a rock star.
That's
true.
And it's also, you know, and come on, it's also what she, like, she kind of got the, you know, get out of jail free card. He divorced her, so she's free to go. Like, how many times are you going to keep putting Deacon off? Like, now you're not the bad guy. You didn't ask for the divorce, so you're good in the kids' eyes. You're good at, like, she's good.
Good.
Go just be with the man you love. Seriously. But no, she can't do that.
But the show, it's got to be. She can't do that because then the show would be over.
Yeah. Right. But I do agree with you. I was a Teddy fan on this one, on how he handled what he said. I thought it was great writing, and I thought we've all been saying that all season long. We're like, look, she doesn't have the look. She doesn't, you know,
the spark
have
is not there.
Yeah, and you know he knows it and feels it. So,
yeah, that's true.
Good. Yeah, I'm glad it happened like that.
All right. Well, do we want to do a little news and gossip?
Yeah. Got a little bit.
AfterBuzz TV News.
Okay, so a couple things. We heard her new song tonight, Consider Me, the one that she sang with Deacon.
Juliette.
Juliette's
new
song. So,
There it is.
Well, now on the Nashville-inspired docu-web series called On the Record, it's live at abc.com/musiclounge, all those original songs are on there, and so it actually shows you kind of the process of who wrote the songs, how they came up with it, recording it, that whole thing. So it's kind of cool. You really get to see what it's like in the music industry and how they come up with the songs. So
and let's give her props. Like we said when we were watching, she really is amazing. Like, her songs are great. You sit up and listen. They suck you in every time.
Great voice.
She's really, really good.
Great voice. She's entertaining, too. I mean, she pulled out some, like, Carrie Underwood-looking clothing and, like, was working it. So.
And, like, she dances, gets into it while she does it. Yeah, I definitely buy it.
Like,
believable.
Well, let's talk a little bit about her, then, since we're on Hayden. But she's apparently back with an ex. It's not her most recent ex, but, and this is going to be a really hard name to say, so... forgive me if I butcher it. Vladimir Klitschko. Klitschko.
I don't know who that
he's
is.
He's a boxer.
He's a boxer.
Oh.
I see that boxer.
He's 6'6".
He's huge.
Really
just
tall.
She's so little.
So, yeah, she was spotted in Dubai with him a couple weeks ago. So, apparently, they're back together. I don't know.
I gotta say, that's this is totally name. Off, too, but that just puts a... just an interesting visual in your head. Like, she's 6'6".
JJ!
I'm sorry, but I've had this discussion with other people before when doing this show. It's like, he's
that's
huge,
funny.
She's
I
tiny.
Know.
How tall is she?
She's like 5'2",
yeah,
I
she's
think.
She's really
she's
small.
Little.
I think
five
on a good
feet.
Day.
Goodness. Well, okay, got a couple other things. I don't,
sorry. I don't even
no,
know.
You're right. Okay, this is interesting about Claire Bowen, who plays Scarlett. She was actually, so she's apparently the most trained singer. Basically, so she goes
out
way
of all
back.
The cast.
Out of all okay. of the cast, she actually has had, you know, experience with it, and she was classically trained in operetta.
I believe that I could hear
from
that
age
in her voice.
Four.
Okay.
Wow. So, and apparently, she has been writing and plans to record her own stuff. So, we'll be.
I can hear that in
that.
Her voice. That like classically
yes,
trained
yes.
Quality.
It's breath control.
It's so
yeah.
good.
Very good.
She really
control.
Is talented. A couple other things. This is kind of funny, I think. The Nashville mayor, Carl Dean, he was actually supposed to be in tonight's episode, and he was supposed to be handing over kind of the reins of power to Teddy, and it was going to be in, like, the courthouse and everything, but they cut him out. So I guess they didn't need that scene, but maybe he'll come back at some point.
There was too
poor
much
guy.
Cheating and kissing happening for that.
Yeah,
would Rayna have been there?
Oh, see?
No.
She was blown back.
Yeah,
but
right.
But kind of interesting because you've seen, like, Vice President Joe Biden was on Parks and Rec, so they're pulling in kind of some of the...
The
some
real
political
the real
figures.
Yeah.
Okay, so the little girls that play Lennon and Macy, really quickly, they did an interview with Vulture, and they were talking about their rise to fame and kind of the things they like. They're obsessed with Harry Styles from One Direction. But this was interesting.
Cute.
They talked about one of the scenes they had to film where they both had to cry in it. So obviously,
why are they going to be crying?
There we go. So we can
Mommy
assume
and Daddy
now
are getting a divorce.
There you go. Okay, last thing I've got for you. The guy that plays JT, Nicholas Strong, he just joined the cast of the upcoming CBS series Under the Dome. And that is based on a Stephen King novel. So he's making moves as
nice.
Well.
Nice. Good for him.
Go Nashville, people.
Yeah, yeah.
That's all I got Nashville. For you today.
All right.
Now are you ready for the predictions?
Best
now, you're
I feel like the UFOs
TV.
Are coming. I feel like there could be so no. many.
This could be the longest strand of predictions mm-hmm. we've ever had at the history of AfterBuzz TV. But we won't do that to you. I think... I can't even... No, I can't. Somebody has to go first.
Okay, I've got one. I think that with this whole divorce thing, Deacon and Rayna, they're going to rekindle their love. It's going to be going really well until he finds out about his daughter. And it's going to all go to hell.
I was going to say, I think that Deacon is going to be pissed when he finds. I think she's going to be,
it's gonna be
really like happy to tell him. And he is going to flip and be done.
Well, that's what I'm saying. I think it's going to really like, I don't know if there's any coming back from that. And so it'll be a huge new turn of events.
And a flip and another flip from the on Rayna is going to flip out when she finds out about Peggy.
Oh, for sure.
Like flip. Mm-hmm.
And I think Peggy's going to. Tell her by accident. I think Peggy's going to be the one to deliver the news to Rayna, and I think she's going to think that she already knows, and then she's not going to know, and it's going to just explode.
And I have to jump on your semi-prediction before that Lamar is going to come in and try and squash the divorce. He's going to be like, you're mayor now.
Doesn't look good.
You're my daughter. This is not happening. And he's going to try and fix that all, and then maybe who knows, maybe what's his name? Deacon's sponsor.
Conrad. No, Teddy Conrad. What is his name? Don't do this to me.
Connor? Whitney forgot.
No bell for you.
Wow.
The
you
running.
The spot
his
like
running.
This?
The who is running
I
against?
I know. It starts with a C.
Isn't it Conrad?
Coleman. Coleman.
Coleman.
Sorry. Give it up. It's all coming back.
Not,
I got it.
We had a week off.
I did not.
Got it.
I did not mean to put you on the spot, but maybe Coleman will leak the Peggy thing. I'm just saying.
What do you got?
I don't know. Well, I was kind of one earlier, which I agree with you that I don't think Teddy is going to be truthful with Rayna, and I think asking for the divorce, but I don't think he's going to say that he slept with Peggy. So I do think that she's going to find out from Peggy.
I have another one a little bit. Well, we saw in the preview, we saw the daughter looking in and overhearing a conversation. Mm-hmm. So maybe she finds out way before her daddy finds out.
Oh man, what if she goes
It's going to be rough.
Before,
I mean, you grow up with
She finds out about
Deacon.
She finds out about who her real dad is, that both of her parents have lied to her for however old she is.
And then
it's going to be rough.
I do agree with you. I thought the peeking in the door, I was thinking in my head that she was seeing Deacon and Rayna talking about it.
I think it could be Teddy and Rayna.
But I think, yeah.
Do you think it's outlandish to predict that Rayna and Deacon will do like a song together, and the way she's going to tell him is she's going to start breaking out with a cover of "That's Just My Baby Daddy." No? Is that not a good prediction?
That's outlandish.
That's not real. That's not realistic. No.
Marissa, you have a prediction?
Sorry.
Well, I think that, yes, Deacon and Rayna are going to get back together, but I think Juliet's going to be pissed about it, too.
Oh, good call.
Yeah, Juliet, she's gonna be alone.
She has this thing about making everything about herself, and she's going to be like, well, what are you going to do for me? You know, like, she's going to
go off on Deacon.
Or if he, like, signed a contract or something, she's got him, she'll figure out a way. I don't know if he did, but.
Juliet's going to get
Juliet is going to come into play for sure.
What if, you know how we saw her hooking up with her producer? What if Juliet's Rayna. Gonna, remember there's a sexual tension between him and Juliet, so maybe she's going to go after him to get Rayna stabbed.
That's fine.
Yeah, that would be great.
Or she'll go tell Deacon what just happened. I don't know.
Overall, we predict it's going to get real messy.
Uh-huh.
Okay. I do think, too, you had a good one about Juliet, because we keep seeing her building getting crazier and crazier again, and we saw that for next episode. Maybe she'll start going on, she'll
and Rayna loses
her being crazy like her mom and start eating her drugs or have her own.
And Rayna loses it, so something happens.
Speaking
like
of
a,
drugs, that's what it seems like.
Who knows? But we could maybe predict something going on there, some chemical abuse or something, or maybe just a nervous breakdown. But we all, I'm sure, collectively will predict that Deacon rescues her.
I know I mentioned it earlier, it kind of reminds me of the movie Country Strong, like they're kind of playing off that when Gwyneth Paltrow she kind of her character ends up overdosing. I don't think obviously that's not going to happen, but it's kind of like why she can't handle the emotions and everything that's happening in her life. What's she going to do?
But she control. I don't know, it seemed like she was on stage when this breakdown is going to happen.
Just happen, who knows. Come on, Deacon.
Oh, it'll be good. Yes. Oh, my gosh.
Well, such a fun show. We had a great time. Thank you guys for watching. Where can we find everybody?
You can find me at KeetinM33 on Twitter.
Perfect. I'm at WhitneyLane1118 on Twitter and Whitney-Lane.com.
And I am at Lauren Leonelli on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and my website.
Waiting for it. Counting all of them.
And I am at JJ Jurgens on Twitter and JJJurgens.com. Thank you guys for watching.
Yay.
See you next week.
From Bing.com, executive producers Maria Menounos, Kevin Undergaro, Phil Svitek, and the entire AfterBuzz TV staff, we would like to thank you for listening to the AfterBuzz TV network. To watch or listen to other after shows and post comments or questions, be sure to visit AfterBuzzTV.com. I'm Sir Richard Wentworth, and this has been a presentation of AfterBuzz TV.
Buzz you later!
The views expressed herein are those of the hosts only and do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principals.